And finally, that brings us to the last model we'll be reviewing here, the DL4. The quick description of the DL4 is easy, as many consider it Dermlite's flagship dermatoscope. So what's so great about it? Well, there's no point in repeating what's already been said, so let me just say this. The DL4 literally has all of the good features of the DL3, of the lens quality, size, lighting, pigment boost technology, and overall build quality, but directly addresses some of the drawbacks of the DL3. That is, first, it just feels more compact and solid. And I mean that specifically in reference to how the DL3 feels like a luxurious, finely crafted instrument, but yet which also feels like it needs to be handled with care. Don't get me wrong, you still don't want to just throw around the DL4, but at least for me, it just feels a little bit more solid and a little bit more rugged, at least so far as how it would make you feel carrying it around with you all day long. And part of the reason, I believe, is because overall it just feels better in the hand. Interestingly, it's actually just slightly heavier than the DL3, but its weight is distributed more evenly, and it just doesn't have that lopsided, heavier on one side feeling that we mentioned with the DL3. Also, its handle is more ergonomic. Just comparing the DL3 in the hand as compared to the DL4, you can see what I mean. It's just easier and more comfortable to hold, and even comes with this silicone sleeve, which adds to its comfort. I also find that it's a bit easier to operate with one hand, again, because of its weight distribution, size, and ergonomics. It's also slightly more versatile with regard to the pigment boost feature. That is, whereas the DL3 does offer pigment boost, its pigment boost lighting is only available in addition to the white LED lighting. However, the DL4 offers pigment boost lighting both in addition to the white LEDs, as well as having a standalone option to use only the orange pigment boost lighting. Now, are there many scenarios in which viewing a lesion with only the orange pigment boost lighting will make a difference? Maybe, maybe not, but at least the option is there. So what's not to like? Well, just being honest, for many people, it's the price. It's the most expensive unit we're reviewing here, with a suggested retail price of $1,395. But as with the other dermatoscopes, on our website, we do offer them for a fair amount less. But discounted or not, it does take a little bit of getting used to when you haven't yet purchased a high-end dermatoscope whose price tops out over $1,000. Besides the price, I would have to say that it does share some of the not-so-pocket-friendly issues of the DL3. Again, it's overall more compact as compared to the DL3. But if you aren't using its belt pouch and instead have to rely on keeping it in your lab coat or pants pocket, you may still find it to be a bit bulky or awkward to carry around. So who is the DL4 ideally suited for? Simply put, if you want what many consider to be the single best overall handheld dermatoscope out there, and you don't mind paying for that quality, then you really can't go wrong with the DL4. However, I would add that it really is best for those who routinely wear belts and are able to use its belt pouch. If you don't routinely wear a belt or even have a lab coat, I do think that you may find it a little bit big or bulky to simply carry in your pants pocket. And over time, you may find that you're not carrying it around with you as much as you'd like to. In those situations, a much lighter unit like the Dermlite GL would be a good option, even if paired up with the DL4 to keep on hand in case you do need something with greater magnification.